Although this kid is smiling, he's actually hard at work, pouring molten metal in a shipyard in Dhaka. Not exactly an ideal environment for a child. Sometimes it's easy to dismiss the influence of an image like this, to assume that the photographer is just another silent witness to an atrocity like child labour, and that policymakers can easily turn a blind eye. But there is proof that a photo like this can have a huge impact. In developing nations like Bangladesh, child labour is a huge problem, with around 5 million children between the ages of 5 and 14 currently employed. Poverty is the driving factor that causes families to send children to work in hazardous and low-wage jobs, such as brick chipping, construction, and waste picking, instead of attending school. In many nations, labour laws exist to protect children, but they are not often enforced. In developed nations like the US, labour laws are strict to ensure that children stay out of the workforce. However, this wasn't always the case. Lewis Wickes Hine from Pennsylvania was a photographer and sociologist in the early 1900s. Now, you may know his work. He took the iconic photos of the workers who constructed the Empire State Building in Manhattan, New York. But his first job was documenting the child workforce of America for the National Child Labor Committee during the Industrial Revolution. At the turn of the 20th century, kids in America could be found working in factories, plantations, and even coal mines. Across the country, children as young as 4 were making glassware, textiles, and cigars. Children worked long hours with minimal pay, and the work was often extremely dangerous, and sometimes deadly. Hines' work also put him in danger, and by all accounts, he received several death threats by factory police and foremen. And that's because at the time, using children in the workforce was something that happened behind closed doors. Hines continued, often disguising himself, sometimes as a fire inspector or Bible salesman, among others, just to gain access to the factories, plantations, and mines. It was Hines' photos that brought the issue of child labor to national attention. Over the course of a decade, he took thousands of photos that documented the practice. His work convinced, and some say shamed, US lawmakers to introduce new industrial regulations to protect children. The photography of Lewis Hine shows that images like these assures that child labor issues continue to stay in the conscience of those who can influence policy. And for the photographers who document child labor all over the world, that's the main motivation of the job. As Bangladeshi photojournalist and humanitarian GMB Akash put it, "I knew that as a photojournalist that it was my duty to tell the truth. But besides that, as a human being, I believe that it was my moral duty to find ways to alleviate the pain of abuse and poverty of those people in my photographs."